Robin, I don't want to end our marriage.
I'm just trying to face the facts.
I made some mistakes. Some big ones. And you're hurt and you're angry. And you've been through a lot, so I'm just asking you not to make any rash decisions.
I'm not. When I was trapped in that well, I had a lot of time to think. I thought about how much I love you.
I love you too. You and Emma are the world to me, and I would do anything for you.
I know, but what chance did we ever have? I mean, come on, when I met you, you were a player. You were the kind of guy who could be with any woman he wanted to be with, who didn't want a commitment. I mean, it was completely unrealistic to think that you could ever change.
I'm not defending what I did. It's indefensible. I was completely wrong.
Right. I don't think that you woke up one day and decided to break our marriage vows.
Of course not.
I'm sure you struggled, and now you're truly remorseful.
Yes.
But that doesn't mean it won't happen again.
It won't happen again, Robin. I promise you that. It won't.
He seems so sincere.
I'm serious. I am committed to you for the rest of my life.
But that's what you said when we got married. When you said our vows in front of everyone that we loved. And then when temptation came about, you still couldn't resist.
Lisa was a one-time thing. I've learned my lesson. I would never, ever jeopardize our marriage again. I love you too much.
Sometimes love isn't enough, you know? Sometimes people are just too different.
How are we different?
Because I want fidelity. I want consistency. I want commitment. That's not who you are, Patrick. I realize that you tried to change for me, but you can't.
I will change. I have changed already.
I don't think that you can be faithful no matter how good your intentions are. I think it's better to end our marriage now.
Giving up on our marriage isn't fair to anyone, especially Emma.
Plenty of kids grow up with divorced parents and they still feel loved and supported. I mean, I'm one of them.
Your parents are a special case.
Every divorce is a special case according to that person. We have to face the truth, you know? We don't make each other happy.
Come on. Robin, that's just not true. We've been very happy. I know we can be happy again.
How? How is that supposed to happen? When I'm walking on eggshells, wondering the next time that you're gonna look at another woman, or, you know, worrying about you when you're supposedly working late at the hospital, or if we have a
trust.
Fight.
Robin, I understand that.
But I just don't see how that is possible.
Marriage is difficult. And divorce is a last resort. And I honestly don't think we're there yet.
Patrick, I've known that you've slept with Lisa for weeks, and I can't get past it. I can't.
Robin, you're not a quitter. We can go to couples therapy. We can...
Therapy isn't gonna change who you are.
I'll go to therapy. I'll figure out why I blow my world apart, where I sabotage everything that's good. You and our marriage, I'll do whatever I have to in order to get you back. I don't want to be without you. You and Emma are everything to me. And I'll do whatever it takes.
But what if the only way to save what's good is by letting go? Remember that time upstairs when I yelled at you in front of everyone at the hospital?
Yeah, you were justified.
But it doesn't matter. I don't want to feel that way ever, ever again.
You won't. Not on my account.
You sleeping with Lisa and how I reacted, it brought out the worst in both of us. You know, Emma's still a baby. She doesn't understand what's going on right now, and I will not risk an upheaval in her life as she grows up.
Robin, You're not giving me a chance here.
Putting you in a position where you have to be faithful is setting us both up for failure. You're a wonderful dad. And I am so grateful for that. You know, I mean, as parents, we do bring out the best in each other. And I really believe that with a little time and with some distance that we can be amicable exes. Maybe even the best of friends.
I don't want to be your friend. I want to be your partner, your lover, your husband, everything that includes. I made mistakes, but it doesn't have to destroy us. It can make us stronger.
Being apart will make us stronger. I mean, look at my parents.
Robin, I'm not talking about your parents. I'm talking about us. Me and you. We have a chance to be happy for the rest of our lives. Robin, I love your parents. And they did an amazing job with you. But it's not exactly an ideal family.
It worked out fine.
Because it was your reality and kids adapt. That doesn't mean it's for the best.
Patrick, I don't want Emma to have to deal with something like this when she's older.
I just think being friends and co-parenting, it's a safe way out, Robin. I don't want that. I want what we promised to each other on our wedding day.
Your promise? Ugh. We're talking in circles.
Well, how about we circle back to reconciliation?
Come on. I mean, this is too soon, okay? I love you. I'm not sure that will be enough. And every time we have this conversation, it's emotionally exhausting. Can you please just give me some time to let it all settle?
Yeah. I'll do whatever you want.
I don't think we should live together. Emma and I are gonna stay with Uncle Mac.
Okay. You don't have to do that, though. I mean, I can go get a hotel or something.
No, I am not gonna stay in the house if we were a family. I won't do it.
Just for the record. This isn't what I want.
Duly noted.
But I really wouldn't want you rummaging around my cranium after the day you've had.
Don't worry about it. The patients are safe. Wouldn't put a band-aid on Emma's doll after the day I've had.
So, what are you doing here?
Robin's here. Don't know where else to be.
Well, Lisa's in a mental hospital, so she can't hurt anyone. You don't have to worry about Robin anymore.
Robin wants to divorce me.
Listen, Robin, you know where I stand on the subject of Patrick. But I have to say, you know, I've never seen a man more determined. This idea we had to trick Lisa into thinking she was no longer a suspect, Patrick made it work.
Look, I know Patrick loves me. But I don't know if I could ever get over this feeling of betrayal. He broke my heart. He broke our marriage. I don't know. I don't know if it can be fixed.
If you want to divorce Patrick, you have my support.